8 months of the season down, this is the time it gets exciting. This is playoff hockey, completely different to league format hockey. This is the Southern Finals, 8 teams, 6 games, 2 champions. By royal decree, this is Alexandra Palace. Hello and welcome to Zero Pucks Given, the UK ice hockey podcast. We're in partnership with the Hockey Art Co, hockey clothing for hockey people, worn by the best and hated by the rest. Listeners to Zero Pucks Given get a 10% discount on everything site-wide at hockeyartclothing.co.uk. Just use the code ZP10 upon checkout to get your discount. And we are now in our final week of sponsorship with Manscaped, redefining the gentleman with top-of-the-range male grooming products. Listen out a little bit later for more details about Manscaped and their products, but you can get 20% off and free shipping of all Manscaped products from manscaped.com when you use the new code ZEROPUCKS20, all caps, all one word, ZEROPUCKS20. Just 1 week left to get those discounts and make sure your boys are smooth for the summer. And we are also on the Sports Social Podcast Network, the biggest sports podcast network in Europe, boasting top sporting podcasts from famous ex-athletes and others. Right, this is episode 100. I'm Ben. Welcome to Zero Pucks Given. I cannot quite believe we've made it to episode 100, and what a weekend for it to fall on. The playoff finals weekend, South 1, South 2, 8 teams, 6 games, 2 champions, taken in by thousands at Alexandra Palace and across the world on the live stream, where I just had the best time commentating with Chris Beale. A real lifetime ambition completed. I would like to thank England Ice Hockey Events team for having me as part of the comms team and extend my thanks again to Tim and Lauren, the cameraman and producer who kept us running through the weekend, quickly sorting any feed or audio issues as well. So thank you to them both, as well as Chris Beale, my co-lead commentator. And Chris and I will be reviewing the season very soon here on Zero Pucks Given. Well, episode 99 covered the semi-final day of the playoff weekend, which saw Basingstoke Buffalo beating the Guildford Phoenix and the home side Haringey Huskies coming through a very attritional tie with the Peterborough Phantoms 2. Apologies for the roughness of that episode. It was put together very quickly, recorded in my auntie's kitchen and all completed on my phone, a throwback to the first few episodes of ZPG. Since the conclusion of the weekend then, Ryan Bainborough, who played in the pipes for Peterborough Phantoms on Saturday, has announced his second and final retirement from the game. So a massive congratulations to Ryan. Enjoy your summer and then enjoy your weekends. Retirements also taking place this weekend for the Solent Devils. Scott Cooper taking a step back from the game after the final at Ali Pali, and very romantically at a rink he used to call home, the oldest active player in the NRHL, Drew Campbell calls time on his career at 47. I spoke with Drew briefly on Saturday after the final. He will recover, have a summer of golf, and then next season he will join me on ZPG to discuss his long, illustrious continent hopping career. So looking forward to that already. So into finals day, a sunny but breezy day on top of the hill in North London as the iconic Alexandra Palace was ready to take on the mantra of a gladiatorial amphitheatre, as Basingstoke Buffalo, with the spirit of the Bison in their midst, with the entirety of the Hampshire-Berkshire borders willing them on to take on the Haringey Huskies, playing a home playoffs for the second time in a row and looking to exercise the ghost of playoff defeats last season when they were beaten at home by the Mustangs in the final. The team that they dispatched in the quarterfinals this year to qualify for the Final Four. As both teams put line one out for the start of the final, the nerves and tensions were palpable in the air. The remaining Streatham and Slough fans, as well as the Solent fans in attendance, adopted the Buffalo, whilst the home fans in with the Chieftains fans were making the most incredible noise for the Huskies. So loud, it was affecting the audio on the commentary mics. But it was the nerves that got the better of the tie, as the first period saw few chances and neither side wanted to make that first mistake. and the first finished 0-0. Into the second, and an early break for the Buffalo as a defensive interception gave Cameron Buckle a chance that he put away to give the Buffalo the lead. The second got even better for the Buffalo when player coach Paul Pets added a second that really put his side in the driving seat. The Huskies weren't quite done with the game though, and they pulled a goal back when John Beldikos fired home from the slot. And very quickly, they made it a tied game when Paul Tyrrell smashed one inside Dan Weller-Evans' near post, making it 2-2. Into the third, and the nerves had returned as neither team wanted to make the mistake that could cost the game. As the third winded to a close and overtime looked to be the destination, a turnover in the neutral zone saw Alex Sanford break free into the Husky zone and show maturity beyond his years. He sat the goalie down and finished with just 90 seconds remaining. The Huskies went empty-netted but were unable to stop the spirit of Basingstoke. After a year of uncertainty that looked set to continue, the Bison remain in the shadows of RG22, but the Buffalo do their bit for the town, the players, the fans and the sport. After the game, Basingstoke Buffalo player coach Paul Pets gave his thoughts to Zero Pucks Given.
Hi Ben, thanks for reaching out to myself and Hals for our thoughts on the game yesterday against Haringey. The game was, we knew it was going to be different to the semi-final that we played on Saturday. We were playing Haringey in their home rink. We knew they were going to come out strong. First period, we had to soak quite a bit of pressure, I think. They started really fast and they were definitely getting the better of us. But myself, Hallam and Simon Beer, our other coach, we tweaked a couple things in between the first and the second period. And I feel the second we dominated the play a lot more. And the chances we got, we were very clinical, really. That's been something that we've been really good at all year, is finishing our chances when we get them. Gave us a good point to go into the third period. Obviously, everyone knows that a 2-0 lead is the worst lead in hockey. Everyone says it. We could see the nerves sort of setting into the boys a little bit. They came out well again in the third. We had to weather the storm quite well, I thought. Although they did get it back to 2-2. And from probably a neutral point of view, people probably thought that they were going to turn it around at 2-2. But we both knew that with the boys in the room, with the experience we've got, we knew that we had complete faith in the boys to get the job done, really, and win the game. Personally, I can really be prouder of the boys for how well they played, not only yesterday, but the whole weekend. They've been an absolute testament to me and Hallam all season. And yeah, it was a great way to finish off the years. Cheers, boy.
On to the South 1 final. The crowd was loud and expectant. I felt the nerves as if I was playing and as I bounced up and down on the commentary gantry, waiting for the sides to take to the ice. Before the face-off, though, I caught up with Solent Devils player coach Alex Murray. Zero Pucks Given in partnership with Hockey Art Co, Manscaped Male Grooming Products, and on the Sports Social Podcast Network. We are pre-playoff final with Solent Devils player coach Alex Murray. Muzzo, how did your boy sleep last night?
Yeah, like a baby, I guess.
Yeah.
I don't know, it's a bit weird. I think we were kind of, as a team, quietly confident. I don't know. You know, maybe we didn't speak about that much before the game, but we did as a team. I think everything just kind of felt right for us. I think the build up to the game, I think last Sunday, kind of best performance of our year, I think, against Invicta. And then we had a really good session Thursday. And a lot of the boys were just talking about it on the way up. You know, we normally beat Shretton once a year and just felt right. And a lot of guys had put a lot of, invested a lot of time into yesterday's game. I think studying whether it was Aaron who played a hell of a game, studying videos of anything video that you could find on the internet about their shooting and delighted. And so I think in terms of sleeping, by the time we got home,
So you traveled all the way back to the South.
Some of us did. I think with the early game, I think, the guys with families and stuff
could have time to get home.
All got home and, able to see family and the likes. And then, I know a lot of guys stayed up and watched the second semi, which looked, a bit more, a bit more one-sided as opposed to ours. But yeah, everyone's excited for today, so fingers crossed.
It couldn't be a more even game. The two sides have gone 2-2 in the league this season, one home, one away each. So it really is going to be a tight one.
Yeah, I mean, they're a great team. They're a great outfit. I think that showed last night with their result. I think we know their strengths. You know, the Bartletts are really important for them as well as their import. So ultimately, we've got to keep it 5-5 and pretty much play a game like we did yesterday. And I think if we do that, we'd give ourselves a great chance. You know, after beating Streatham, I think we're confident playing anyone, really.
Absolutely, and so it should be. The performance yesterday, it showed a lot of grit that you say that the lads always have, and that you always beat Streatham once a year. You hadn't done leading up to that. So were you in the back of the mind almost expecting that you could do it?
Not expecting. You know, there's no way you can turn up against the four-year league champs or whatever they are and expect just to win. I think the guys had a good feel yesterday. I think we got here nice and early. We're a really close team, and we had a great warm-up off the ice. Just everything building up to it just kind of felt right for us. And you kind of have to have a little bit of luck. And I think, you know, we Aaron made some great saves. I wouldn't call that luck, but, you know.
He was dialed in yesterday, yeah, wasn't he
was ready to play, and so was a lot of guys. I think the early goal helped, because, as I mentioned in my post-game on the Devils, is that we do like to play a bit of a counter-attacking, you break us down kind of game. And if you go behind early in the game, that's sometimes a bit harder to manage. But look, we're here. We've played Chelmsford twice in the last 5-6 years in the finals, albeit in South 2 back then, and we're one apiece then as well. So ultimately, this trilogy will be a great event, and hopefully something that, you know, we can look back on with fond memories.
Will do. What an iconic venue to do it in as well. The last games, of course, are Drew Campbell and Scott Cooper. So we'll look forward to them guards of honour at the end of the game.
Yeah. It's been a great event. You know, I was a little bit, you know, skeptical, about, you know, what it would look like this weekend, but it's been really well organised. It's great to see the Division 2 finals here as well, and actually some of the younger players and the quality that they bring just watching those games, and that will allow for progressions for them as well. But yeah, hopefully we can, as the showpiece final, put on a bit of a show, and like I said, fingers crossed, we're the ones lifting that cup at the end.
Also before the game, I caught up with Chelmsford Chieftains head coach, Lewis Clifford.
Zero Pucks Given in partnership with Manscaped Male Grooming, Hockey Art Co, and on the Sports Social Podcast Network. We're pre-game of the playoff finals with Chieftains head coach Lewis Clifford. How are you doing, Cliff?
Yeah, I'm all right, mate. Thanks. Yeah,
good to be back. After last night?
No, not really.
No, quite an exciting game.
Yeah, got home probably about midnight, watched a bit of NHL, trying to get to sleep, and I think I was awake about 6:30 this morning. Just bing, that was it. So yeah. I've been up. But yeah, no, I think weekends like this are always a bit like that. There's a lot of adrenaline, obviously. Not so much for me, but for the players. And I think, yeah, we're all really buzzing and excited, ready to go.
And keeping the heads after going 1-0 down to a short-handed goal early, hitting straight away back on that power play was vital, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. You know, I'm not going to lie and pretend that I thought that the game was going to go the way it did. I was confident, but I never saw that scoreline coming. I think the boys executed the game plan almost to a T. Discipline was very good, and we'll have to be again tonight. And you know, we were clinical when we got chances, we took them. Whether it was 3-2, 4-2 or 9-2, irrelevant really. A win's a win, and here we are.
That's what it is, I suppose, in these knockout games. It's irrelevant, as you say, the result. It's just a win is a win. But 8 unanswered goals coming back from that, the boys must have been absolutely buzzing.
Yeah, I think they were. I think now is, well, not now, but from that point onwards is time to manage your emotions, not get too high, just like we didn't get too low when we went 1-0 down. Just stay level, you know, and we've got to stay level again today, level through the weekend, you know. Getting up too high when things are going well, or getting too down on yourself when things are going badly, is not going to end well for anybody. So, yeah, just keep level, keep level-headed. I know we will with the experience we've got in our room. And then, you know, I was very impressed with Solent yesterday. Saw two periods of their game, and should be a great game.
I'd say the fortunate thing going second is you can actually have a little scout of your potential opponent for the following day. So, yeah, as you say, Solent did quite well. But it's exciting for the whole league, I suppose, to have two different teams going for the playoff title.
Yeah, I think it is. I kind of fully expected probably like 90% of the people in the building, other than probably the Solent team, who had a lot of belief. I expected, when I walked in, it was 1-0. I thought Streatham would overturn that. And I was wrong, you know. Solent did a really good job. They're very good. Like, they're very tight defensively in the house. They keep most things to the outside. And Streatham did start finding a way through, I thought, towards the end. And then when they did, the goalie played out of his skin as well. So, Solent really impressed me yesterday. You know, Streatham, I've said to you before, the best team in the league, but you know, every dog has its day, and You can't win all the time, and Solent fully deserved to be there, and it should be a good final.
And what a way to finish the season, this iconic venue, a fully packed crowd as it was last night, incredibly loud as well. And good luck for the final, Cliff.
Yeah, thanks.
Great toast off to the season.
Yeah, our fans were unbelievable last night. I don't always hear them at home because of just where the bench is, and I think a lot of the noise comes from the far side of the rink. But with them being behind us, it was loud last night, and we need more of the same tonight. And I know we'll get it. And can't wait to get going.
As the gold jerseys of the Chieftains lined up against their black jerseyed counterparts, after some confusion as to which team should be on which bench resulted in them both being in front of their rivals' fans, that stoking the atmosphere to an electric level as Thrower dropped the puck to get us underway, and has both teams tried to exert the dominance, both buoyed, of course, by fantastic wins on Saturday. A neutral zone turnover saw Baldock poke the puck to Grant Bartlett, who went in on Aaron Taylor and showed the same clinical form he was in on Saturday as he gave the Chieftains the lead on just 56 seconds. After Chelmsford had received the too many men bench penalty, Solent evened up the numbers as Luke Forsyth went to the box for high sticks. And in the 4-on-4, good offensive work by King and Jameson saw Damon Porter finish well from close range, as he demanded the noise from the Chieftains fans. Into the second, and the Chieftains took another too many men penalty. And from the first face-off, Coleman won the draw, Murray with the shot, tipped in from the slot by Mark Pitts, putting the Devils on the board in the final. But just as Solent did when Stretton pulled one back Saturday, Chelmsford regained their two-goal advantage when Grant Bartlett fed Cameron Bartlett, who smashed past Taylor for 3-1. Right at the end of the second, a fast break by Alan Lack saw the puck slid across to Cam Bartlett, whose close-range effort dinged off the iron. The Chelmsford fans chanting VAR to the commentary gantry, but our replay confirmed the puck hit the bar. Into the third, and the Chieftains again started early as great work by Grant Bartlett squeezed the puck across the crease for Cam Bartlett to keep the Bartlett show going as these two lads continued to cement their legendary status at Chelmsford after both passing the 500-point mark this season. As the Chieftains continued to push, Cam Bartlett Jameson saw their passing exchange result with the puck heading to the stick of Grant Bartlett, who scored his sixth goal of the playoff weekend when he slapped a beauty of a one-timer into the far top corner for 5-1. And he wasn't done there when Baldock laid on the assist for Grant Bartlett to complete his second hat-trick of the weekend, making it 6-1, notching his 91st point of the season and killing the game off. As the seconds counted down, I was struggling to contain my emotions in the commentary gantry. As the buzzer went, the players all embraced Jordan Lorday. For the Devils, it's the second final loss in a row. And after the weekend had settled in, Alex Murray gave his thoughts to ZPG.
I think, first of all, I just want to start off by personally thanking you, Ben, for all you've done this sort of last 12 months with ZPG. You know, it's been really great to speak to you most weekends, whether it was a high or a low. And the exposure that you bring for our league and our sport has been, has been really beneficial. And you're a great guy in terms of, you know, how you sort of present and how you speak, and it's been a great, you know, privilege to be able to do that with you. So I just wanted to start off by saying thank you to you, and obviously look forward to working with you again moving forward. Looking at the weekend, I'm sure everyone will understand there's obviously mixed feelings there. You know, some of the very highs on the Saturday to the very lows on the Sunday. I mean, I'll start off with Saturday, and I think, as I've said in some of the interviews already, since we just kind of had such a good feeling going into that game, I think we owed Stratton a performance, and, you know, hockey gods and all the rest of it, whatever you want to call it, it was just our game. You know, we changed the lines. We went with a combo of Liam, Pitsy and Kane, which we haven't done this year yet on the top line. We just kind of felt that was right. And, you know, to get three of the four goals was, a good decision, I think. And, you know, we got the lead and we never really looked back. And I think they got into a bit of penalty trouble. And whilst we weren't that potent on the power play, I think he just kept momentum for us. And, you know, we were able to, you know, set ourselves up in our defensive, you know, blocks and our traps, and made it a bit difficult. I think, you know, Aaron Taylor stood on his head, but he did so much work building up to that game in terms of, you know, preparation of you know, the opposition and where they shoot and like to shoot. And he really was the main reason that we were able to qualify, because Streatham did come hard and
And yeah, once we got that lead, as I mentioned, he backed us all the way to that victory, and it was great. You know, so many people wrote us off, and we lost Chico. And whilst Chico was an outstanding goaltender, you know, Aaron is able to write his own little story there on Saturday. So yeah, the guys were excited, you know, after Saturday, but it was about controlling that emotion. I think last year was one thing for sure. I think we. Given the result last year in against Invicta, we weren't quite able to control that emotion, and I think that impacted us on the final. But we were much more controlled and calm this year, and again quietly confident going into the final. I just think conceding so early in the final like we did last year is the most frustrating thing. I can't quite explain, but we had talked so long about the Bartletts and their impact in the game and how they've matured over the years, and they've always been great, you know, great goal scorers. But you know, when you've got a team around them and a great coach in Cliff, you know that they were always going to be a problem. And so conceding early against the fast counter attacking opportunistic team like Chancellor was going to be hard. We got caught on the break a few times, whether that was pushing extra D-man in the zone or, you know, or having long periods of defensive pressure where we're then looking to try and get guys off the ice and they counter-attack so quickly. So yeah, I think, you know, as I'm sure you know, the final was a bit of a devastating blow to us and a real shame. But I couldn't be more proud of the boys, of where we bounce back every year and prove people wrong. And we can look back on this year again as another positive, but ultimately we're not happy. You know, we're not content with always being there or thereabouts. And I think that, you know, we deserve some recognition of that. And whilst people's words are great, I think we would just keep plugging away till we get, you know, to get our hands on that trophy. And I think we won't give up until we do. But, you know, overall, it's been a great season. It was a great weekend ran by Danny and his team. And I can't thank everyone enough. And our supporters were great, whether they were at home watching on the stream or there in numbers on the Saturday and Sunday. We can't thank you enough. So that's it for another year for us. We'll be back at it. Obviously, it doesn't really stop for coaches and stuff. So we'll be working behind the scenes tirelessly, ready for a new year. Thank you very much.
And once his voice had returned, that's right, Chieftains fans, he's here. Lewis Clifford gave his thoughts to Zero Pucks Given.
Well, it's tough to, you know, to sum up that weekend without being like massively proud and massively over the moon with what we achieved. It's been an up and down season, definitely more ups and downs. You know, I think I've probably used the word inconsistent or inconsistency 1,000 times over the last couple of weeks. And that's been the case for us ever since we really got going. And we just found it at the right time of year. That's how you win the playoffs in this country, with the short format and everything. You have to come in hot, you have to come in flying for a couple of weekends. And that's exactly what we did. And I honestly believe when we play like we did over the weekend, it's very tough for any team in our league to stop us. And the boys were absolutely outstanding, and I honestly couldn't have asked for any more over the last two weekends. I'd just like to say, though, you know, none of this happens without having legit teams to compete against and compete against all season. And I watched the second, third period of the Solent game on Saturday. I felt for Streatham a little bit. I felt like you get that sometimes when you've been winning. Sometimes you have a bit of a drop, a bit of a lull, and they just had it on the wrong day. Having said that, Solent were absolutely good value for their win and deservedly in the final. And I knew that we'd have to play a very smart game, a very disciplined game to beat them on Sunday. But we had to take care of business on Saturday first. And I woke up on Saturday, and I knew we were going to win. And it's not often that I get that. It's definitely not from a place of arrogance. It's very rare that I wake up and just go, we're winning tonight. I normally think, yeah, we'll win. If we do that, we'll win. But I woke up Saturday and we're winning tonight. And that thought never left my head, although I never said it to anybody else until the game was finished. But, I think Slough came out to play hard against us, certainly gave us a bit of a run for our money and a bit of a scare early doors. But again, like I said, when we play like we did, it's very tough for another team to live with us. And And the boys were outstanding all weekend, from front to back, across all of the lines. Everybody was popping in and helping and chipping in with points and goals and shot blocks and everything that they needed to do. I'd just like to just say, like, I'm hugely proud of what we've achieved. This is just a start at the moment for us as a group. But I'd like to congratulate or thank, really, the other teams in the league that have given us battles all year. Every team in the league's given us battles this year. But congratulations to Streatham for winning the other available trophies. And to Slough and Solent for giving us battles over the weekend. You know, you have to get there in the first place. And that's not to be sniffed at, getting to the Final Four weekend. It's tough. You know, I've been there, I've done it, I've lost finals, I've lost semi-finals before. It's not nice. It's horrible when that's the last game of the season and you're not going to play again. But fair play to you guys for getting there. And like I said, thanks to everybody else in the league. And just thanks to everybody in Chelmsford. Obviously, everybody that helps us out off the ice, whether it's the owners, the backroom staff, volunteers, all the fans that come and watch us on the weekend. Everybody's made my life so easy coming there as a newcomer this year. It's been great to be a part of, so thank you for that. But most of all to my team. The boys are phenomenal this weekend and last weekend, to be fair, and I couldn't have asked for any more from every single one of them. There wasn't one player that I came away from the Oxford weekend or on Saturday night or Sunday and thought, oh, he could have done a bit more. Oh, he was okay, but you know, like everyone was outstanding, and I'm really proud. I've probably used that word too much in this little segment, but thanks a lot to everyone. Thanks to you, Ben, and the other guys that are trying to raise awareness of hockey around the league, because we need more eyes on it. It's a good product, this league, and it's getting better and better again. It goes sort of in cycles, but this league's getting good again, and we need more people watching it. So. Thanks a lot to everyone for tuning in, everyone who's bought a ticket to any rink in the league this season and made noise and provided, you know, part of an atmosphere to make this league relevant. I've had a long year, as you can probably tell from my voice. I'm done now. I need some time off. My players need to rest and recover. And they fully deserved that, and I need to rest my voice. So on that note, thanks a lot to everyone for tuning in. We'll see you in September. Cheers. Bye-bye.
Well, what a weekend. That's not the end for the coach's thoughts, though. Obviously, losing in the playoffs is incredibly emotional. These one-game knockouts can take time to process, especially when it hasn't gone your way. So after the dust had settled, Streatham Redhawks player coach Ben Painter gave his thoughts to ZPG.
Yeah, firstly, I just wanted to congratulate Basingstoke Buffalo and Chelmsford on their success over the weekend. Obviously, Basingstoke got a lot of good friends in that team that a bit of adversity of last year or two or whatever, and losing their boyhood team, and then obviously question marks around an ice rink that's been their home for the best part of their career. So, for them to get that win, and I'm sure it meant a lot to them, and I'm pleased for a lot of those lads that managed to get that done. And then on to Chelmsford, they were brilliant all weekend. I think they dominated. I think it's fitting that the team that turned up both games on the Saturday and the Sunday took home the title. So yeah, congratulations to them, and obviously a couple of great individual efforts. Bartlett's, for example. But as a team, I think they played well as a team all weekend, and yeah, as I say, best team of the weekend took home the trophy. So I mean, from our point of view, bitterly disappointed. I don't think we were anywhere near our best. I think we went into that game knowing we had to be at our best to get anything out of it. That's a team, they work hard, they battle hard, and I think they came with a game plan, they stuck to it, and we didn't. Essentially, we were nowhere near where we needed to be. So I think, yeah, it's disappointing. We know that obviously we won the league and won all the trophies up for grabs up until that point, and we've had to do so by being consistent and sticking to what we do, and we didn't do that, and we paid the price of obviously an early exit out of the playoffs. So it's a difficult one. I mean, we had a great third period. I think we really, really sort of dug our heels in the third, and I think I felt like we, if we had played the whole game like we did the third, we probably would have been a different result. But I mean, a couple of individual sort of mistakes early on, myself with probably the biggest mistake of the night, to be honest, puts us one down within the first couple of minutes, and from that point we're chasing the game and can't really find any sort of rhythm. And yeah, bitterly disappointed with the performance, to be honest with you. But I'd just like to just make a sort of special mention to our supporters that have been with us all year. We've got a great group, and there was plenty of them at Ali Pali over the weekend, and they were loud all throughout the game. And it's great to see that we've got such a great group of supporters that, you know what, they are, even when things don't go to plan and we don't have the success we hope for, they stick with us, and they really are a great group. So yeah, congratulations to the teams on their success, and hopefully we can regroup now and head on to Coventry and hopefully get that one that we sort of haven't managed to get over the last couple of years. So yeah.
Looking at the weekend as a whole, for me, I think it was a success. Four games in one day is a squeeze. The 10:30 face-off is not ideal, but it's the same for both teams. It didn't really affect the quality of the game. The Chieftains deservedly crowned champions, so clinical and disciplined over the weekend. For Solent, possibly mentally exhausted after having to play a play to counteract every stress and play. Just as a hockey fan, it was great to see two new teams in the final. Which I said to Dawn, the lovely owner of Streatham, to which her wonderful response was, you can't win them all. But as a hockey fan of South One, I'm right behind the Streatham Red Hawks as they head to Coventry in 2 weeks to face the Billingham Stars in the sort of Division One national playoff. So I would imagine if you've been listening, or you were at Ali Pali or watching the stream, you know exactly where this is going.
Hi, it's Justin Wong, Kenny Wu from the Muddy Ducks, presenting Zero Pucks Given Britain Division Player of the Week.
The player of the week then. Well, last week he took the quarterfinals by storm, as the last time the Chieftains made the finals in 2022, he was injured. There's no two ways about it either. He was missed. But this season, he's been back to his very best. Goals, assists, general team play, leading by example. After smashing the Southern finals to bits with 7 goals, 3 assists, 1 trophy and making it a 91-point season, this week's player of the week is Grant Bartlett. A massive thank you to Petsy, Muzza, Cliff and Paints for taking the time to give their contribution to Zero Pucks Given. I genuinely appreciate you giving your input into the podcast. It makes it what it is. And as we reach 100, not out, I'd like to thank everyone who has listened, followed on socials, liked or shared the social media posts. That really does make a big difference. Thank you to all the guests that have been on in the last 100 episodes. I've loved speaking to each and every one of you. Thank you to all the clubs I've visited as an away fan this year. You've all been so incredibly welcoming and generous. And thank you to England Ice Hockey again for allowing me to commentate on the biggest game of the season. What an honour. I truly hope it's not the last time, and I cannot wait to watch them back. So a massive thank you again to you all for listening or watching. Thank you to the coaches for providing their thoughts. And of course, thank you to Hockey Art Co, Manscaped and Sports Social Podcast Network for being part of the Zero Pucks Given family. Make sure you're following on all the socials, Instagram, Facebook, X, Threads, Snapchat, and TikTok. And of course, you can subscribe on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and YouTube, especially for the lot of new people that I met this weekend. It was lovely to meet so many of you. The next episode coming soon will have my team of the year, my roster of the year, with an invite for you to do your own as well. And I will also be catching up with Great Britain captain Jodie Alderson-Smith after the Lionesses just missed out on a medal at the World Championships in Riga in Latvia. And as we finish the ZPG season with Chris Beale, as we will dissect the Britain Division season from bottom to top. Into the summer, I'm thrilled to announce that I've actually been invited onto a project with former ZPG guest Nick Rothwell, who will be doing some very honest and hard-hitting interviews with former athletes, and I will be the producer for the project. So very much looking forward to that over the summer. Thank you so much again for listening. 100 not out. I'll see you next time. Hey guys, it's Ben from Zero Pucks Given. We've had our sponsorship with Manscaped extended by 1 month. So you've got one more month to get your 20% off and free shipping on all of Manscaped products from manscaped.com. As you can see from this before picture, I know I look like someone who used to be in good shape. I'm a little bit of a gorilla. I'm quite a hairy guy. So I took the Lawnmower 5.0 into the shower, and then with the interchangeable head, you take the long hair off with the clipper head, you flick it off for the razor head, and then you take the short hair off. And considering how hairy I am, this is the outcome. I think that's pretty darn good. Of course, once of there, it looked like a bit of a plucked chicken, and you kind of go all the way down, use the skin safe razor blade, the clipper blade, and that downstairs to get all of that cleared off. And then when you're done, you use the crop soother and the crop preserver, which is like a deodorant for your balls. Stops any of that sweating, any of that chafing, if you're sort of driving a lot, sitting in a van all day or something like that, or even if you're being active, going to the gym or training or anything fitness wise, it stops from all of that rubbing and chafing, particularly when you wear the Manscaped boxers that are also in the picture, as they've got a nice sort of silk pouch at the front which keeps you all feeling nice and fresh. So then after that, I've used the weed whacker to get all the hairs around from up my nostrils and in my ears, which as you get older, trust me, they all start to appear out of nowhere. And then I've used my moisturisers with a little bit of bulldog stuff, actually, to just on my head after I've shaved that with a razor blade. You can get a Manscaped beard trimmer as well, which is something I'm definitely going to look at. It's got a lot of different attachments on it, so you can sort of do the lines in your beard and sort of skin fade it down, which is a really, really good product. I'm hoping I might get hold of one of them quite soon. So, yeah, I think these products are absolutely brilliant. I do not put my name to anything that I don't like. And as you can see, I use them. And I think they're great. So use the code ZeroPucks20, manscaped.com.